What's wrong with my seatbelt? It won't open. The door! It's jammed! Open up! The lock is broken. What's going on?
Hello?
Is this Claire Washburn?
Yeah.
Miss Washburn, my name is Hank Tipton. I'm with the California Highway Patrol. We've got a crime scene up here off 101, just south of Cypress View.
Not my jurisdiction, officer. I'm strictly San Francisco forensics.
I know, ma'am, but it appears we've got a bit of a special case on our hands. You see, your name was left at the crime scene.
I'm sorry?
Your name. It was written in lipstick on the windshield of a car where we found our victim.
That doesn't make any sense. Do you know the name of the victim yet?
Yes, ma'am. Woman by the name of Regina Blacklock?
My God. Regina. I'll be right there.
Morning, ma'am. The paramedics removed the body from the car trying to revive her. I didn't see a point in putting her back. Otherwise, no one's touched anything.
Thank you.
Send her to the San Francisco Medical Examiner's office?
It's not our usual jurisdiction, but yes, ma'am, if you authorize it. Is she a relation?
A very dear friend.
I'm sorry for your loss. It looks to me like carbon monoxide poisoning. We find them sometimes, especially in the cold weather. People leave their motor running, take a nap, tailpipes faulty or maybe blocked. Then again, sometimes it ain't no accident.
I'd like to look around.
Sure. Give me a call when you're done, and I'll notify the tow truck.
Thank you. Hello?
Lindsay? Claire, is that you? It's Regina. She's dead. Claire, I heard. I'm so sorry.
Are you there? At the crime scene?
She was killed, Linz. I know it. Her tailpipe was rigged and she had sleeping pills in her coffee.
My God.
I think she was up north working on a book. A little town called Cypress View. I need you to look into it.
Of course, Claire. Anything I can do.
And Lindsay, please get this guy.
Sorry about that. I was just restocking in the back room and didn't hear you come in. Anything I can help you find?
My name is Lindsay Boxer. I'm with the SFPD. I'm here investigating the murder of Regina Blacklock.
Oh, yes, I heard about it. Terrible news.
I noticed this newspaper article written about her. Seems she didn't get a warm welcome here in town.
Not exactly, no. Folks didn't like her being here, digging around. I'll be honest, I didn't much like it myself, but I'm not one to get involved. The past needs to remain buried, Detective. No sense sticking your nose where it doesn't belong. Oh, where are my manners? I haven't introduced myself. Randy Boren. This here's my shop.
Nice to meet you, Randy. If you don't mind me asking, what do you know about Sutter Ames?
I'd be careful throwing that name around town, Detective. It conjures up some terrible, ugly memories for folk. Short version is, back in, 75, I believe, young local gal named Mandy Malone went and got herself killed, chopped up into bits. Sutter Ames was the town weirdo at the time, had himself a camp out in the woods where he and his followers would get naked and dance around a fire or some such. Some strange stories came out of that place.
Was Mandy Malone part of Sutter Ames' group?
Sure enough. In fact, that's where they found her body. At Sutter's camp. It seemed pretty obvious to everyone who killed her, but the police were never able to find evidence to prove it. Didn't take long before old Sutter skipped town. No one's heard from him since. And that's pretty much the whole story. You need anything else, Miss Boxer, you be sure to ask.
Thanks, Randy. I'll do that.
Hey, you need something fixed up? Carburetor, alternator, what you got?
No, thank you. I'm actually investigating a murder. Regina Blacklock?
Blacklock. Oh, right. Young gal, writer or some such. Out of towner, right?
You met her?
Did some work on her car. Real nice set of wheels. Shame about her dying, you know.
Is there any way that her car could have been tampered with while it was here in the shop?
Nah, it's just me here. And I didn't kill her. I keep the place locked up tight when I'm gone. Come to think of it, I did find a hole in my fence a couple days back. Looked like somebody cut through it. Of course, nothing was missing, so I just patched it up. It's over there behind the paint mixer if you want to take a look.
Do you think someone broke in?
Look, I got like a million things to do. And like I said, it's just me. I gotta run.
Okay, thanks for your time.
Hello there. Any reason why you find it entirely necessary to set up all our festival decorations again? It's over, you know. Finished yesterday.
I'm sorry. I'm looking into a murder. I believe the victim was here at the festival. Just trying to piece things back together, get a better picture of what was going on. Lindsay Boxer, SFPD.
Sally Waters, Town Council Secretary. Is this about that author that's been snooping around?
Yes, Regina Blacklock. Do you know of her?
Pretty small town. We were all a bit worried about her being here, digging up old wounds. Cypress View is all about tourism, and it took us 20 years to recover after Sutter Ames. Nobody wants to visit a place where people get killed by devil worshippers. At least, not most people.
Miss Waters, do you remember who was serving coffee yesterday at the festival?
Just about everyone on the town council helped man the coffee table. Even the mayor put in his time. I don't remember seeing Miss Blacklock at the festival, if that's what you're getting at. Then again, I was pretty busy.
And would you mind giving me a list of the town council members?
I can assure you, Detective, if you're looking for a murderer, then the Cypress View Town Council is the wrong direction. You won't find anything but upstanding citizens with roots in the community. And if you'll excuse me, I need to find someone to clean up all these decorations.
Miss Waters, if I could just... That didn't go well.
Hello?
Cindy, it's Lens. You in the office?
Yeah, what's up?
I need you to look into an old cold case for me.
How cold?
35 years, give or take.
Right. Actually, they call that a frozen case, Lindy.
I have a feeling this could be big. There's some kind of connection to Regina. She was here looking into this case, and she ended up dead. I need you to come up to Cypress View and dig around for me.
Dig around? You mean do the same thing that got Regina killed?
I'll owe you one.
I'm Miss Connors, the librarian. Can I help you find something?
Nice to meet you, Miss Connors. I'm Cindy Thomas. As a matter of fact, I was admiring your town history shelf. Someone's been a very diligent record keeper.
Oh, yes. We have a historian on the town council. We're very proud of our heritage.
I'm impressed. But I noticed that the 1970s volume is missing. Maybe someone checked it out?
Well, those books don't leave the premises. The volume you mentioned has been placed in storage and is not available to the public. Now, if there's nothing else, I have work to do in the back.
But, okay. Thank you.
Hey, Cindy, you find anything juicy yet?
Yeah, I was able to find a photo of all the people that worked at the coffee stand at the festival. The one that gave Regina the drugged coffee.
Anyone stick out on that list?
I think so. I also stumbled into the storage facility at the library where they were keeping the town history books under lock and key. Completely by accident, of course.
I didn't hear any of this.
They had the Manny Malone murder case documented pretty well. Apparently this Sutter Ames character was the prime suspect.
Yeah, I heard the name. Who is he?
Some sort of cult leader or something. Sounds like he was into real freaky stuff. And he had some of the folks in town following him, including Manny Malone, the girl that got killed. They couldn't pin the murder on him, and then he disappeared.
Any idea who was following Ames? If Regina was sticking her nose into this, it might have scared somebody that was close to him.
Yeah, I managed to get my hands on a photo of Ames and his supposed followers from 1975. I compared it to the photo at the festival, and we've got three people in common that were in Sutter Ames' group and served coffee at the festival. Beverly Connors, Randy Boren, and Sympathy Morgan.
Impressive.
I thought so too.
Sounds like I've got a few people to shake down. Thanks, Cindy.
I'm Miss Connors, the librarian. Can I help you?
Yes, I'm Detective Lindsay Boxer. I'm investigating the death of Regina Blacklock.
Oh, I read about that. Tragic, but an accident, surely.
Perhaps. I wanted to talk to you about Sutter Ames. I heard you were a follower of his.
Me? Not at all. I'm very religious, in fact. Anyone can attest to that.
According to this old newspaper photo, you were a follower of Ames.
I guess I was fooled for a short while. I was ignorant to the fact that Sutter Ames was aligned with the dark forces. But that horrible night got my head straight in a hurry, I can tell you.
The horrible night?
When Mandy was murdered, of course. Yes, that's us in the picture. Me, Randy, Winston.
Winston?
Winston Laramie. He was a local school teacher. Seemed old to me at the time, but I suppose he was merely in his 30s. He died years ago. Lung cancer, I think. Randy Boren runs the general store. He inherited it from his father. You better talk to him yourself. Sympathy Morgan is a local craftswoman. She was a follower of Ames. Might still be if he was around. She's into Wiccan and oh, heaven knows what all. She runs the Crystal Barn. I can give you a map. The masked man in the picture? I'm afraid I don't remember who he is. He came around occasionally, a friend of Sutter's, I think. But I don't remember his name. I'm sorry.
One more thing, Miss Connors. What did you see the night Mandy Malone died?
I saw Sutter kill Mandy right in front of my two eyes. Clear as day. Well, you know, it was nighttime, but you know what I mean.
And you were of sound mind?
I'm sorry?
You hadn't been drinking or taking any psychotropic drugs?
Well, I may not have had all my faculties in order. It was the 70s after all, but I assure you that I know what I saw. Sutter Ames killed that girl. Whether or not he knew what he was doing is between he and God. I really can't discuss this anymore. Goodbye.
Is that Mr. Boren? Randy Boren?
Can't talk now. Store's closed.
This is Detective Lindsay Boxer, police. Will you come down, please?
I'm holding up a 40-pound branch, so no. Some fool borrowed the town's electric saw and didn't return it, so I'm stuck with this doggone antique. I'll be done sometime next year.
Mr. Boren, it's Detective Lindsay Boxer again. Are you ready to come down?
God blast it, no!
I really need to get into your store.
Sorry I was out. The loom is fun, isn't it? I give classes on Sundays.
It is fun, actually. Sympathy Morgan, I presume? I'm Detective Lindsay Boxer, SFPD. I came to talk to you about Sutter Ames.
Oh, well, sure. I have no secrets. If anything, people tell me to just shut up already about Ames. I'd been with him for a few months when he moved here. And I came along, and when he left, I stayed. I never meant to spend my life in Cypress View. But I guess the universe had other plans. So how can I help? I remember that guy, but never knew his name. He was some Hollywood big shot. He gave Sutter money. He hung around for the women, me included. He was the first to disappear when it all hit the fan. While Sutter wasn't into devil worship, the papers had that all wrong. He was just an old-fashioned pagan, green goddess, Mother Earth, Bacchus, that sort of thing. He wasn't even a very good pagan. Mostly it was about nature, sex, and drugs. Hardly unusual in the 70s. Randy was just a big-eyed local kid at the time. You know, the sensitive type. His dad didn't like him hanging around us. Not one bit. After Mandy died, Randy dropped us like a hot potato. Everyone was ready to believe Sutter did it. That was a bad time. I never believed Sutter did it. His religion didn't run that deep or his blood that cold. Besides, Mandy was gorgeous. All the men wanted her. Why would they destroy such a beautiful thing? Unless it was an accident. I wish I remembered more about that night. But I was so out of it. People thought I was lying. But I really don't know what happened.
I like your latest design, The Betrayed. The black rose represents Mandy, doesn't it?
Yes, she certainly was betrayed. But then, so was Sutter. So was I.
What do you mean?
Sutter was betrayed because everyone was ready to believe he did it. Most of his followers left him to fight alone. As for me, I stuck by him. And then he snuck out of town without taking me or even telling me.
The newspapers refer to Sutter's camp. Where is it?
Not far from here, just through the woods. But you can't get to it anymore because Mayor Atkins put up a gate at the front of his road which leads up there. His sawmill's up the road and he was sick of kids vandalizing the place.
Thanks, I appreciate your candor.
Hey, like I said, I'm an open book. Come back anytime.
Hey, Randy. I found the electric saw.
Really? Hand it up to me.
It's amazing what the right tools can do. Dang, City Council insisted that tree be trimmed for the festivities next week.
You're very active on the City Council.
Yeah? Why?
No reason. I wanted to talk to you about Sutter Ames. You followed him for a time.
Hey, I was 18. He had the best party in town. End of story. Mandy was special. Really beautiful. And not like the other girls, all free love. Mandy held herself back a bit. I was too shy to approach her. What happened to her was beyond horrible. Worst thing that ever happened in this town. She didn't deserve to die like that. I thought he was the cat's meow, at first. He was a smooth talker, had all these big ideas, a philosopher. My dad was just a shopkeeper, you know? I guess Sutter Ames represented something better. But after Mandy died, it opened a lot of people's eyes. I never went back there.
So you think he did it?
Did he do it? Well, I thought so at the time. I gotta go. I've neglected my store today. Thanks for the saw.
I'll be in touch.
There you are. I've been looking everywhere for you.
You have?
Yes, I thought of something last night. You mentioned that you're trying to get to Sutter's camp.
Right, but I can't use the path through the woods. It's blocked off, and I haven't been able to get through.
Well, I remembered hearing that you could get to Sutter's camp through the old mine.
You know this for sure?
No, not really. Just a rumor. Figured you'd want to know.
Of course. Thank you, Sympathy. I'll definitely look into it.